Hey YouTube, what's going on? This is iTalk. Here, and in today's video, we have a brand new video. This is the second video for the day today. Make sure you check out the first video I put out today. There's a lot of juicy information in there that I think you guys will definitely like. But for today's video, we're going to cover one of the topics that we talked about earlier because now it's been confirmed what it's actually for. Fortnite on Twitter said, "Venture back to the edge of the galaxy. The Galaxy Cup is back. Android players compete in the cup for a chance to earn the new Galaxy Grappler outfit and more." They link to the Fortnite website and here's what they have to say. The Galaxy Cup returns on August 29th, 2021, which is actually very soon, it's 4 days from now. Compete in the Android Galaxy Cup 2.0 for a chance to unlock a brand new outfit, back bling, and wrap before anybody else. Galaxy Cup 2.0 will be a solo competition and the first ever Arsenal LTM Fortnite tournament. We've selected this mode due to its tight match length and popularity in the mobile community. In Arsenal, all players start with the same powerful weapon, and eliminating a player grants a weapon of slightly lesser power. The first to make it through every weapon from best to worst earns the Victory Royale. For this cup, a Victory Royale rewards you 7 points and each elimination rewards you 1 point. You also get a point for playing in each match. Players in each region can win the Galaxy Grappler outfit, Hands of the Galaxy Backbling, and Vortexual Wrap. All players who earn at least 20 points will be awarded the Llama Galaxy Spray. Winners will be determined as follows per region. So for the wrap, it says right here, here's what you need to do, here's what you need to be in the top of. Seems rather simple. If you want to obtain the outfit and the back bling, it's pretty much the same thing as the wrap, but it's like half of it. So if you want to obtain the Vortexual Wrap in the NA East region, for example, you need to get to the top 10,500 players. And if you want the skin in NA East, you would have to get to the top 5,250, which is half of that. So that's basically how they're going off of it. They say players can compete in a maximum of 25 matches in the region's 3-hour time window, and the specific timing for each region can be found in the compete tab in game. Note, the Galaxy Grappler outfit, Hands of the Galaxy Backbling, and the Vortexual Wrap will be available in the item shop at a later date. They also say here, the OG Llama Galaxy Spray will be available to all players who earn at least 20 points. That spray was kind of rare. Like, I think you had to obtain like an Android phone case to get it, and it wasn't available to everybody. I think it was pretty expensive. I think it was like 30 bucks. I think that was like the price that people were selling it for. I'm not entirely sure exactly how much it was selling for, but I think that was around the price tag. So my thoughts on this. So I talked about it in my video before for today, and I said that I hoped that this skin would be an exclusive skin. I've said before, and I'll say it again, I miss when Fortnite did exclusives, right? Remember back when we had the original Galaxy skin? Remember when we had skins like Royal Bomber, Double Helix, Neo Versa, Eon, Dark Vertex, Surf Strider even though I really don't like that skin? I miss when we had actual exclusives, and I know you think the same way. I'm not saying that I'm trying to gatekeep skins from other people. I don't want to be like, I want every skin to be exclusive so only I can obtain them because I can afford them. That is absolutely not what I'm saying here. What I'm saying is that I wish we had more hype with skins again, and exclusives were an easy way to hype up cosmetics. Yes, this is a timed exclusive. This will be available in the item shop, I guarantee you, a month after this tournament. That's essentially what happened with the Galaxy Scout skin, where this was pretty much the exact same thing, except it was for BR and it wasn't for Arsenal. And if you obtained it, it didn't come out into the item shop for like 3 to 4 weeks. So it was a pretty good flex for that amount of time. But with this, it's now like, you know, it's the same exact thing. And I think overall, that's great. People are going to be able to get a skin for free and early, and I think that's neat for everyone. But I'm disappointed because it's a reskin of Galaxy Scout. And usually I would like to think that reskins should just be exclusive. Eon is a reskin of the Criterion skin. Double Helix is a reskin of the Archetype skin, right? This is a clear rehash of the Galaxy Scout skin. Now, yes, there is some different things with it. The hair color is different. The thing going around it is different. The galaxy inside the body is different, but it's basically the same thing. The back bling is completely different as well. But I'm just like, I'm kind of at a loss here. It's like, I would have preferred this to just be an exclusive skin for Android owners or the new Samsung, whatever they're promoting nowadays. I think that would have been a cool exclusive. I still hope out for Xander. I hope Xander is a full-on exclusive skin, because again, I like when skins are exclusive because it gives them a bit more pizzazz. It brings hype to the community. You know it brings hype to the community. Remember the Merry Mint pickaxe? People still run that pickaxe, and it was an exclusive one, and people still liked it because it was exclusive and not everyone could get it. Now, I did kind of like what they did with the edit styles if you owned a PS5 or an Xbox Series X, but I really just miss when skins were just flat out exclusive. I feel like everything has to be timed. Everything has to be given to everyone. And I want there to be some more exclusivity in the game again. I would really like that. We haven't had a real skin exclusive since Surf Strider, which was a while ago. And then the last exclusive we had was the Wildcat accessories, which I didn't think was worth it much at all. And it's just, I don't know. I feel like I'm so alone on this. I feel like people are gonna think that I'm just wanting everything to just be for me and for no one else, when in reality that couldn't be further from the truth. If that was the case, I wouldn't tell you guys how to get these certain skins. I wouldn't tell you guys what was going on in Fortnite and what I thought about everything. Like, I would actually tell you guys how to obtain a free wrap, which you can obtain today, or how to obtain this skin. I would hide it all from you. If I really just wanted this to be all for me, I would never talk about this sort of thing, but I'm talking about it here today because I just wished it was an exclusive skin, because there's not enough done to the outfit for me to be like, yeah, that could have been an item shop skin. It would have been better if it was just an exclusive, and I'm a little bit miffed about it. Yeah, I'm a little bit annoyed about it. I'm not gonna lie, I genuinely thought that this was gonna be a full-on exclusive. I will try for the skin, by the way. I did win Galaxy Scout last time, so I will try it here. But I don't know, I'm a little bit disappointed. I want to know what you guys think. Do you think I'm overhyping it? Do you think I'm over-exaggerating when I say, oh, I want these skins to be exclusive? And do you think I'm some sort of bad person for wanting that? Because I kind of feel like I do take things a little bit seriously with Fortnite, but at the same time, it is my job to cover Fortnite stuff, and I'm just starting to slowly get back into the swing of things with content. Everyone's going back to school, so Fortnite content will most likely get more attention again, because not everyone is playing the game and they don't know everything that's going on, so I can keep you guys up to date with everything. I'm very excited for the future of Fortnite. Like, seriously, like, there's a lot of cool things going on with it, but again, it's just with this little thing here, I do wish that some things weren't just a participation trophy. I don't think everything needs to come back into the item shop. I don't believe that Renegade Raider and Aerial Soul Trooper should be sold in the item shop. Those were exclusive to Season 1. Keep it that way. I don't necessarily care that those skins won't come back. I would like reskins for Aerial Soul Trooper, though, because I think that would be a neat idea. I don't want the actual Aerial Assault Trooper to come back, but a reskin of it, I think, would be a good idea. It would give people the benefit of knowing what it would be like to actually own the skin without actually owning it. I would like to see more of that, and I just feel like everything is so easily obtainable nowadays, and there's no hype for any exclusives anymore. And I miss it, man. I really do miss when we had exclusives. Like, I think we had exclusives like, what, twice or three times a year? And now we barely get anything at all. So I really do hope that Fortnite pumps out more exclusive skins in the future, because they are hype. There's a reason why Wildcat is so popular. There's a reason why there's other skins that are so popular, is due to exclusivity. And I would like to see more exclusives come out of Fortnite. But guys, that is genuinely just my opinion. Again, please let me know how much of a virgin I am in the comments down below. So guys, that is it for the video today. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. If you did, let me know with a like and subscribe to the channel if you're brand new. And if you like to use me for support a creator, my code is ITF. It's very greatly appreciated. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you all later. See ya.